Welcome to the Maryland Department of the Environment's Water Quality Maps tutorial. Here are the instructions for using MDE's web-based water quality maps. It should be noted that these maps perform best with the latest version web browsers such as Internet Explorer 9. Start by going to MDE's homepage and in the search bar in the upper right-hand corner, type Water Quality Mapping Center. Then click Enter. The first result that comes up is the Water Quality Mapping Center. Please click on this link. At the Mapping Center page, you are given two options: the Integrated Report, also known as the 303D list, or Tier 2 High Quality Waters information. For the purposes of this demonstration, we'll pick the Integrated Report maps. This next page provides you with 12 different water quality maps, each displaying a unique set of pollutants. We'll explore the nutrients map to see how it works. Please be patient to allow the map time to load. You are initially presented with a view of the state symbolized according to 8-digit watershed. This provides only generalized information, so the user should zoom in to see more detail. Using either the roller wheel on your mouse or the plus button on the left, zoom in to see higher resolution information. To pan, simply click on the map and drag the map in the direction you need it to move. You can also enter an address, town center, or coordinates in the upper right-hand corner of the map window to zoom to a location of your choosing. Clicking on the legend button allows you to see what the colors symbolized. At this point, you may want to change the base map to something more useful, such as an aerial photo. Click on the water body to display a pop-up window that provides specific water quality assessment information for that stream. You may need to pan the map to see the entire pop-up window. Here you will see the integrated report information, including locational information, when the water body was first listed, listing category, and information about any TMDLs that may have been completed. Please note that if a TMDL has been completed, there will be a link at the bottom of the pop-up window. Click on the link to access the TMDL page. Please also note that when you click on a water body, it may be assessed for multiple pollutants. You can tell by looking at the top of the pop-up window. If numbers such as 1 of 4 are displayed, you'll need to click on the Next Feature button to go through the list of assessments for that water body. In this case, the county is given as additional information for the location where you've clicked. Another feature of these maps that you may find useful is the View Larger Map link at the bottom of the map. Clicking on this link will take you to the ArcGIS Online Map portal. We'll zoom back into the Anacostia River watershed to show you how this works. You'll notice that this map provides some additional functionality not available with the embedded web maps. For example, you can deselect certain layers to limit the information that is displayed. I'll show you how that's done. You can also add other layers by using the Add Data option and clicking Search for Layers. The toolbar at the top provides a number of other useful features, including the ability to make both distance and area measurements, find coordinates, and zoom to bookmarks. Perhaps one of the most useful features is the ability to share the map that you have made. Clicking on the Share button will bring up a window that provides a URL. This URL can then be shared through a variety of means, including email, Facebook, and Twitter, so that others can view your customized water quality map. The other integrated report maps and the Tier 2 High Quality Waters map work much the same way as the nutrients map. I encourage you to explore these maps and to use them for your water quality planning efforts. Thank you for your interest in restoring and protecting Maryland's water quality.